So let's look first at the zeros. Zeros. So let's first look at that. And let's just leave our poles aside and just have a look at the at our general function, which is 1 minus rz e to j omega z, and then z to minus 1, and then multiplied by 1 minus rz e to minus j omega z, z to minus 1. And let's make it even more special that we say that rz is 1, yeah, so that we eliminate this here, and that we just say that our omega z is omega 0, and that also later on this is also the same for omega p for the poles. And so let's write this down like this here, 1 minus e to j omega 0 to z to minus 1, and then 1 minus e to minus j omega 0 z to minus 1. And so now what we can do is we can just multiply this here out. Yeah, so this gives us here 1 minus, and then we've got here the omega 0 term here, so e to j omega 0 z to minus 1, and then we're getting another e minus e to minus j omega 0 z to minus 1, and then the last bit here is this product here, which gives us here e to j omega 0 multiplied by minus j omega 0 z to minus 2. And so this one here gives us 1, so this goes away. And then we've got here 1 minus z to minus 1, and then we can write this here as e to j omega 0 plus e to minus j omega 0 plus z to minus 2. And so this we see already here, this looks like a classical IFIR filter here. So this is here essentially an FIR filter, which we can further explore now. So let's write this here down here again. So that's our FIR filter. Let's take a new sheet here and copy our result for our FIR filter on this one. Then we can have a play with this filter here a bit, or make it also even simpler. So this was 1 minus z to minus 1, and then e to j omega 0 plus e to minus j omega 0 plus z to minus 2. So this one here is nothing else than 2 times cosine of omega 0. So we see already that our coefficients all becoming real. So that's the complex aspect of this one here goes completely away. And so we have just revalued coefficients. This is a general rule: if we have complex conjugate zeros, that's the coefficients becoming real. So our first coefficient here, this is a 1. Then the second coefficient here is this 2 times cosine, so that's the first coefficient. That's the second coefficient, and then this here in the 1 multiplied, so that's the third one. So if we, so with that we can directly draw a circuit diagram. So we need two delay steps. And so the undelayed part is just going straight to the output. That's the same for the delayed part with two steps. So we can have a summation unit here. And this is just the weight 1 for the first one and for the delayed by 2 time steps. So the one with 1 time step also goes obviously in the summation, but this is multiplied by minus 2 times cosine omega 0. So that's our input x of n, and that's our output y of n. So that's our filter here, and this is obviously classical FIR filter. So an FIR filter with 3 tabs. Not very exciting compared to our FIR filters we used before with 100 of tabs or so. But we can have a look what the frequency behavior of this is here depending on this omega zero term here. Yeah, so we've got this frequency dependence. Frequency response. So the frequency response in digital filter is just calculated by this term here. So that's the amplitude that we are after. So in our case here, if you're writing down our original function, then this looked like 1 minus e2 j omega 0 z2 minus 1, and then this multiplied by 1 minus e2 minus j omega 0 z2 minus 1. So we see instantly that this writing style is quite convenient to see what's happening if we are substituting e2 j omega here in this. So 1 minus e2 j omega 0, and then this is here e2 minus j omega, and then this is 1 minus e2 minus j omega 0, and then this is e2 minus j omega. So now what we see here is that this here becomes 0 for omega equals omega 0. And this one here becomes 0 for omega equals minus omega 0. So our frequency response looks roughly, so if this is here omega and this is here our h of e to j omega, that our frequency response looks like this, that we have 0 transmission at this frequency omega 0, so that we got this dip here and another one at omega minus omega 0, and this goes from minus pi to plus pi. So in other words, there's 0 transmission at frequency omega 0. So this means 0 suppresses 1 frequency, or complex conjugate 0 suppresses 1 frequency. So do we see this also in the time domain? In the time domain, so remember our filter was h of z, and then this is 1 minus and then 2 cosine omega 0 z2 minus 1, and then plus z2 minus 2. And so this was our FIR filter with two delay steps here. And so this one was just the weight of one. So this is here multiplied by minus 2 cosine omega 0. And this one is here again just the unity here. So that's our filter here, x of n and y of n. So now we could have as an example special case. Let's say omega 0 is 0, so this means DC. So we should be getting a filter which is eliminating DC. Eliminating DC. So is this true? So let's have a look here at H of Z, and that's 1 minus, and then so at DC, this is here 0, so the cosine gives us a 1, so this gives us a 2, so 2 z to minus 2, and then plus z to minus 2. So the question is, so does it work for DC? So if we have our filter again, so that's why that's still a 1, then this is here now multiplied by minus 2. And this is here again our 1, and we sum this here up, and that's our output here y of n. And so we see instantly if we are sending something like a constant signal here. So if we say x of n is always 1 equals constant here, then this gives us here a 1, this gives us always a minus 2, and this gives us always a 1 here. So the output here in this case then is 0. In case of constant input, which is essentially a DC. So this works. So let's summarize this here. So far, summary zeros. So the most important aspect is they suppress frequencies. So the zero creates a certain damping of a frequency, suppressed frequencies or damping of frequencies. So they cannot create frequencies, they can only remove frequencies. So that's essentially that FIR filters use many zeros to create the desired frequency response.